Dear students, so we are going for the next step in the animal kingdom, that is NCERT based year. In the previous three videos we have discussed up to that mollusca here. So now it's a time to go for Echinodermata here. We have already completed the important theory plus important questions related with the mollusca. So now we are going to discuss the important points related with the Echinodermata here. So first we are going to discuss the important point related with the Echinodermata here. As per NCERT, Echinodermates, they have an endoskeleton of calcareous oscills. So what are present in the Echinodermates? They are having an endoskeleton which is made up of calcium carbonate here. So they are having the calcareous oscills. That's why the name is given as the Echinodermata, spiny bodied animals having dermal oscills. That's why they are known as the Echinodermata. They are having the calcareous oscills that are responsible for the spiny appearance here. So the body is echinous, it means having the spiny bodied animals. And why the spiny bodied animals? Because the calcareous oscills which are present, they are giving the appearance like spiny appearance here. In some, spines are modified into pedicellary. So pedicellary, they are present in the Echinodermata, which are useful for defense and cleaning the body. So what is the function of pedicellary? Defense and cleaning the body. And the pedicellaries are modified, they are the modified spines here. See, next, all Echinodermates are marine, without exception, all Echinodermates are marine, organ system level of organization, no parasitic form is there. Very important, in adult Echinodermata, the type of symmetry is the pentamerous radial symmetry, and in larva, that is the bilateral symmetry here. Diploblastic animal known, coelomate animals known. Now, digestive system is complete, it means tube within a tube body plan is there. Mouth is present on the lower side, it means on the ventral side, and anus is present on the upper side, means the dorsal side here. The most important character of the Echinodermata, that is the presence of water vascular system, that is also known as the ambulacral system. Water vascular system or ambulacral system, and this water vascular system is helpful in, it is helpful in locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. So what is the characteristic feature of Echinodermata? Presence of water vascular system or ambulacral system, that is the characteristic feature of Echinodermata. And what are the functions of this ambulacral system or water vascular system? Locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. These are the three as per NCERT. These are the functions: locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration here. Very important, in all Echinodermates, the excretory system is absent. What is absent in Echinodermates? Excretory system is absent here. Sexes are separate, it means they are the dioecious. Reproduction is sexual, very important. In Echinodermates, the reproduction is sexual. Fertilization is external. What is the type of fertilization? External. Development is indirect, it means larva stage is there and they are having free swimming larva in their life cycle here. Examples: Asterias, that is known as the starfish or sea star. Asterias, sea star. Echinus, sea urchin. Antidon, feather star. Cucumelia, sea cucumber. Ophiuria, beetle star. So these are the examples related with the Echinodermata here. So these are the important points you have to remember related with the Echinodermata. These two representative, Asterias, that is known as the starfish or sea star, and Ophiuria, that is beetle star. These two examples are given in NCERT here. Now we are going to discuss some important questions related with the Echinodermata here. Dermal oscills are found in Echinodermata. And what is the example here? Sea pen coelenteata, sea hare mollusca, sea lion jellyfish mammal, and sea lily. That is the sea lily. If you will see, what is sea lily? We have discussed now that sea lily, that is here, that is the example of the Echinodermata here. So you have to remember, they are asking dermal oscills, they are present in the sea lily here. Most distinctive feature of Echinodermata is the presence of water vascular system. Direct question from NCERT. It is helpful in locomotion. It is helpful in capture and transport of food. It is helpful in respiration. So it is not helpful in the nervous stimulation here. larvae of echinodermates are having, we have discussed that larvae are having the bilateral symmetry and adult echinodermata, they are having the radial symmetry here. Which of the following system is absent in echinodermata? NCRT given clearly the excretory system is absent in the echinodermata here. Sexes are separate in echinodermata, sexes are separate. Reproduction is sexual, fertilization usually external, and development is indirect. These are the four features related with the echinodermata. Sexes separate, then reproduction sexual, then fertilization that is the external, and development that is the indirect here. So this you have to remember related with echinodermata here. Now coming on another question here, consider following statement, and they are asking that choose from above which are true related with the starfish. They are asking which is true related with the starfish here. Starfish means example of the echinodermata. Water vascular system is present, so A is there. Adult with radial symmetry, larva with bilateral symmetry, correct. Indirect development, correct. Excretory system is absent, correct. So all the four characters are correct related with the echinodermata. So what is answer? A, B, C, D here. Group of exclusively marine animals. Okay, it's a very good question. Porifera, Nidaria, echinodermata. See, poriferans are marine except spongula, fresh water sponge. Nidarians are marine except hydra, fresh water polyp. And echinodermata, all are exclusively marine and free swimming, that free living, no parasitic form. Masticatory organ present in echinodermates. Just see, radula in mollusca, gizzard and crop in birds and in cockroach also. Aristotle lantern, that is the specific masticatory organ which is present in the echinodermata here. So what is answer here? Aristotle's lantern. Getting position of mouth in echinodermates given clearly in NCRT. Mouth is present on the lower side or on the ventral side. Getting mouth is present on the lower side or on the ventral side here. So what is answer here? Lower side or on the ventral side here. Now we are going on the next phylum, that is known as the hemichordata here. Hemi means half, chordates. And previously the hemichordata, it is included in phylum chordata as a subphylum, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. What is the reason? Previously they were thinking that they are having the notochord, but it is not notochord, it is the stomochord. It is not notochord, it is the stomochord. So now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. Previously it was placed as a subphylum in the chordata here. Now just see, it is consist of a small group of worms like marine animals, organ system level of organization known, bilateral symmetry, diploblastic, coelomate, their characters again and again repeating here. Now body is cylindrical and composed of an anterior proboscis, collar and trunk. What are the three parts of the body? Proboscis, collar and trunk. The longest part is the trunk. So anterior proboscis, middle collar and posterior trunk is there. Circulatory system open type, but here heart dorsal in position here. Respiration takes place through gills. Circulatory system open type, respiration takes place through gills, excretion by the proboscis gland. Getting sexes are separate, fertilization external, development indirect. And what is the name of the larva of Hardmania, that is hemichordata, that is the tornadia larva. Here you have to remember two examples, Balanoglossus, Sacoglossus. Balanoglossus known as the tongue worm, or it is known as the acorn worm here. So you have to remember, circulatory system open, heart dorsal, respiration by gills, excretion by proboscis gland, sexes are separate, fertilization external, development is indirect here. Getting a true notochord is absent. True notochord is absent and it is a part of the digestive system here. True notochord is absent and it is a part of digestive system here. So now we are coming on some questions related with the hemichordata here. Okay, now see hemichordates. First one, they are asking excretory organ in Balanoglossus given in NCRT, excretion by proboscis gland. Getting type of fertilization in Sacoglossus, external. Sacoglossus, Balanoglossus, example of hemichordata, external. Circulatory system in Sacoglossus, open. Circulatory system, it is in non-chordata, so open. रेस्पिरेटरी स्ट्रक्चर इन बेलोनोक्लॉसस गिल्स, गेटिंग रेस्पिरेटरी स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज द गिल्स. या नाउ कमिंग ऑन स्लाइटली डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन, चूज करेक्ट ऑप्शन फ्रॉम एकॉनबम फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग. एकॉनबम मीन्स बेलोनोक्लॉसस, एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फाइलम हेमिकॉर्डेटा. ओपन सर्कुलेशन करेक्ट, फ्रेंजियल गिल्स करेक्ट, किडनी नो नो दे आर नॉट हैविंग किडनी, नो क्लोज सर्कुलेशन सो सेकेंड गॉन. मैरीन गिल्स नो दैट इज एक्सटर्नल फर्टिलाइजेशन. डॉर्सल हार्ट करेक्ट, गिल्स करेक्ट, इनडायरेक्ट डेवलपमेंट करेक्ट. सो वॉट इज द करेक्ट रिलेटेड विद द एकॉनबम, फोर्थ ऑप्शन इज फोर्थ, डॉर्सल हार्ट, गिल्स, इनडायरेक्ट डेवलपमेंट. नेम ऑफ लार्वा, नेम ऑफ लार्वा दैट इज नोन एज द या दैट इज नोन एज द टॉर्निडिया लार्वा, सिडिफिडिन टीनोफोर. ट्रोकोफोर इज अ कॉमन लार्वा ऑफ एनलिडा एंड मोलस्का. एम्फीब्लास्टुला दैट इज इन वी कैन से एम्फीब्लास्टुला, स्टीरोब्लास्टुला दैट इज एग्जाम्पल वी कैन से हियर दैट इन पोरिफेरस लार्वासा दे आर. सिडिपिड टीनोफोरा, सिलेंट्रेटा टीनोफोरा, कॉमन लार्वा ऑफ एनलिडा मोलस्का, टॉर्नेरिया इन हेमिकॉर्डेटा हियर, गेटिंग. बेलेनोग्लॉसस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द टंग बम, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द एकॉन बम, सो मोर देन वन ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट. हुक बम एनसाइलो स्टोमा ड्यूडेनम. स्टोमोकॉर्डल स्ट्रक्चर प्रेजेंट इन, इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द बेलेनोग्लॉसस दैट इज नोन एज द एकॉन बम और दैट इज नोन एज द टंग बम हियर. नाउ स्टोमोकॉर्ड दैट इज द बक्कल डायवर्टिकुलम, बक्कल डायवर्टिकुलम मीन्स पार्ट ऑफ द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम हियर. नाउ स्टोमोकॉर्ड इन हेमिकॉर्डेट एक्सटेंड्स इनटू प्रोबोसिस रीजन, इट एक्सटेंड्स इनटू द प्रोबोसिस रीजन हियर. सो दिस इज एन एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, स्टोमोकॉर्ड इन हेमिकॉर्डेट एक्सटेंड्स इनटू द प्रोबोसिस रीजन हियर. नाउ वी आर कमिंग ऑन द नेक्स्ट फाइलम दैट इज नोन एज द कॉर्डेटा हियर, द नेक्स्ट फाइलम दैट इज नोन एज द कॉर्डेटा हियर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट रिलेटेड विद द कॉर्डेट्स हियर. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फर्स्ट रिलेटेड विद द कॉर्डेट्स हियर. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by, what are the basic characters of chordates? Presence of notochord in any stage of life. First character, presence of notochord in any stage of life. That is the first character of Chordata, presence of notochord in any stage of life. Dorsal, tubular, hollow, nerve cord is present. Dorsal, tubular, hollow, nerve cord is present. And presence of paired pharyngeal gill slits in any stage of life. So these are the three basic chordate character: presence of notochord in any stage of life, presence of dorsal tubular hollow nerve cord, and presence of paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are the characters of the chordates here. Bilateral symmetry, triploblastic, coelomate, organ system of organization known. They are having a post-anal tail. And what is the type of circulation? Closed, exception urochordata that is having the open circulatory system here. Now just see here, they ask one question. Which one is a common feature of amphioxus, frog, seahorse and crocodile? So amphioxus that is the cephalochordata, frog that is the vertebrata, it is also vertebrata, crocodile that is also vertebrata here. So which is common in chordates here? Which is common in chordates? Pharyngeal gill slits, at least in the developmental stage. Pharyngeal gill slits, at least in the developmental stage here. See, this is the representation of chordates here. That is nerve cord. On the dorsal most side, it is the nerve cord. Then it is the notochord. On dorsal most side, nerve cord. Then it is the notochord here. These are the comparison between the chordates and non-chordates. Like notochord is present in chordates, absent in non-chordates. Central nervous system is dorsal, hollow and single. In non-chordates, it is the ventral, solid and double. Pharyngeal perforated, pharynx perforated by gill slits. Gill slits are absent in non-chordates. Heart is ventral, heart is dorsal if present. Postanal tail is absent in non-chordates here. Now, phylum Chordata, it is classified into three subphylum. Urochordata, Cephalochordata, Vertebrata. On the basis of the position of notochord, phylum Chordata is classified into three subphylum. If the notochord is present only in the larval tail, urochordata. If the notochord extends from head to the tail, persistent throughout the life, cephalochordata. And if the notochord is converted into the bony or cartilaginous endoskeleton, then it is known as the vertebrata. Urochordata also known as the tunicata. So just see, it is classified into three subphylum on the basis of the notochord. If notochord present only in the larval tail, urocordata, tunicata. Notochord extends from head to the tail and persistent throughout the life, cephalochordata, and notochord converted into vertebral column, then it is known as the vertebrata. Urocordata, cephalochordata, together they are known as the protochordata. So what is protochordata? Urocordata plus cephalochordata, it is known as the protochordata, and it is exclusively marine. It is present in marine water. In notochord, I already told, notochord in the urocordates present in the larval tail. Cephalochordate, it extends from head to the tail region, persistent throughout the life. Examples of urocordata: Ascidia, Salpa, Doliolum. These are the examples given in NCRT. Example of cephalochordata: Branchiostoma, Amphioxus, or Lancelatia. Now, see, in which of the following chordates circulatory system is open type? In all chordates, the circulatory system is closed, but there is one, that is the urocordata, in which the circulatory system is open. And what are the example of urocordata? That is the doliolum, as per NCRT, doliolum, salpa, ascidia. So what is answer here? Doliolum. Just see, amphioxus, cephalochordata, petromygon, cyclostomata, amphioxus also known as the branchiostoma. Getting amphioxus also known as the branchiostoma. Now, in cephalochordate, the basic chordate characters are present, persistent throughout the life. It means both in larval stage, both in larval stage and in the adult stage here. Which of the following organism not included in protochordata? They are asking which is not included in the protochordata here. Semi, which is not included in the protochordata? Doliolum urocordata included, amphioxus cephalochordata included, doliolum salpa that is included, petromygon, okay, it is in vertebrata, cyclostomata, so not included. What is answer here? 4, Ascidia. Now we are coming on the next phylum, that is known as the vertebrata here. Just see, the members of subphylum vertebrata. Why it is known as the vertebrata? Because the notochord converted into the vertebral column, that is cartilaginous or bony, in the adult here. All vertebrates are chordates, whereas all chordates are not vertebrates. Why it is so? Because just see, the notochord is present in all chordates, but in vertebrates only, the notochord is converted into the vertebral column. So all vertebrates are chordates, all chordates are not vertebrates here, getting? Because in all chordates except the vertebrates, vertebral column is not there. Besides the basic chordate characters, they are having ventral muscular heart, getting? 2-chambered, 3-chambered, 4-chambered heart. They are having kidneys for excretion. They are having osmoregulation. They are having paired appendages, and these paired appendages may be fins, or this may be limbs here. This is the classification given related with the vertebrata in NCRT. It is classified into two: agnatha, nathostomata. In agnatha, jaws are present. And agnatha means jaws are absent. A means absent, natha means jaw. Jaw absent, so it is known as the agnatha. It is including one class, cyclostomata, petromygon. Nathostomata, the jaws are present, divided into super class, Pisces and tetrapoda. Pisces, super class, including two classes here, cartilaginous fishes, condylarthrix, bony fishes, osteatrix. Tetrapoda, amphibia, reptile, birds and mammals here. Just see, all vertebrates are chordates, correct? But all chordates are not vertebrates, correct? Which one of the following is a chordate but not vertebrate? Just see, petromygon, what is petromygon? If I will say, it is vertebrata. Hippocampus, vertebrata. Macropus kangaroo, vertebrata. Amphioxus, cephalochordata. So it is a chordate but not vertebrate here. Now, we are coming on important class, that is known as the cycloistomata. Cyclo means circular, istomata means mouth. That's why it is known as the cycloistomata. Cyclo means circular, istomata means mouth. So it is known as the cycloistomata here. So this one is about the cycloistomata. All living members of class cycloistomata are ectoparasite on some fishes. Very important. All living members of class cycloistomata, they are ectoparasites on some fishes. Very important. The cycloistomata, all living members of class cycloistomata, they are ectoparasite. and to whom they are ectoparasite on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration. So how many gill slits are present? 6 to 15 pairs maximum. When we are comparing the cartilaginous fishes, bony fishes and cyclostomata, maximum number of gill slits 6 to 15 pairs are present in the cyclostomata. They are having sucking and sublamine mouth and it is agnathamous, so without jaw. Body cyclostomes is divide. Divide means absent of scales and paired fins. It means they are not having scales and paired fins. Cranial and vertebral column are cartilaginous. Very important. Circulatory system closed. They are marine but migrate. It means Spectromygon is marine but migrates for spawning to fresh water. This is known as the anadromous migration. After spawning, within a few days they die. It means they are not able to come back here. That is the anadromous migration here. Larva of cyclostomes, that is the amosity larva. After metamorphosis, please underline this, after metamorphosis, return to the ocean. This is known as the catadromous. Adult Petromygon showing anadromous. Larva of Petromygon, that is the amosity larva, showing the catadromous migration here. Example, Petromygon, that is known as the lamprey, mixing, that is known as the hagfish here. Just see, jawless vertebrate, that is the Petromygon here, getting. Incorrect related with Petromygon, you have to remember all the lines related with the cyclostomata carefully. Ectoparasites on some fishes, correct? Correct, absolutely correct, it is absolutely correct here. 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration, correct? They are having sucking mouth, circular mouth, with jaw. No, cyclostomes are agnatha. The jaw is absent. Body is divided of scales and paired fins, correct? So what is not here? That is the with jaws, without jaws. What is answer here? 3. Correct related with Petromygon. Okay, they are asking correct related with Petromygon. Adult Petromygon migrates from fresh water to the marine water. That is incorrect. It migrates from marine to the fresh water. Adult Petromygon shows anadromous migration. Yes, that is known as the anadromous, marine water to fresh water. Amosity larva shows anadromous. No, amosity larva shows catadromous migration. Amosity larva after metamorphosis. So what is correct here? That is the 2 here. Getting? Now coming. Maximum number of pairs of gill slits are present in Petromygon, without exception Petromygon here. Cyclostomes are marine, they are marine, no exception, no other statement marine. Structure present in mixing scales, paired fins, jaws, gill slits. So what are present in mixing? Gill slits. They are divided of scales and paired fins, agnatha. Larva of Petromygon return to the ocean after metamorphosis, NCERT language, after metamorphosis it returns into the ocean. So we have completed here, that is up to the cyclostomata here. Now we are going to discuss some important points related with the Pisces here, okay. In the next video, we will see some important points related with the Pisces, up to the Pisces, amphibia, reptile, birds and mammals. Okay, thank you. All the best.